Hey guys, this is Scott from Scott's Bass Lessons. This tutorial is talking about how to build speed and your technique on the bass, but is directly related to and following on from part one of this tutorial. So if you haven't seen it, please go to my website, scottsbasslessons.com, and check that out. Otherwise, you'll be a bit lost. So we're going to stick to the C major scale that we were playing beforehand. Previous tutorial we were talking about descending down the scale and building speed that way. So when it comes to ascending, other things are in play. Okay, so again, it's the string crossing that starts mucking things up. Okay, so be aware of the string crossing. We're going to do the same thing. Okay, I'm just going to ask you to play three notes of the C major scale, but instead of playing, I want you to start with the B, okay? So B, C, D. Okay, so let's start it relatively fast. Ba-da-da, two, three, four. Ba-da-da, two, three, four. Three notes. One, two, three, four. Ba-da-da, two, three, four. Now we're going to put the E in, okay? Two, three, four. Three, four. Three, four. Three, four. Three. Now the F. Three, four. Three, four. Three, four. And the G. Three, four. Three, four. Three, four. Now, if you haven't seen my tutorial on how to alternate picking exercises for the right hand, check that out as well. That is a must. You won't be able to do this fast enough or at all if you haven't got the alternate picking down. So check that tutorial out if you haven't already. I'm going to carry on. So we got to the G. Okay, so 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4. Now to the A. 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4. To the B. 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4. And the C. 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4, 3, 4,
economy of motion, it's keeping them small enough to make the movement fast enough, make the next movement recover and get in there fast enough. It's economy of movement on this hand, okay? Don't be doing this. You know, don't lift the fingers off too far. They should be over the strings and ready to play. It's about your right hand picking, making sure you do playing alternate on the way up and alternate on the way down, or raking on the way down, which is what I do. So you've got to get all these combinations right and then do the exercises that I've been showing you over the last two tutorials, making sure that you add one note at a time and don't take it too fast. Understand that it's going to take time. It might take you, you know, a couple of weeks, 3-4 weeks even, just to get, you know, 4 or 5 notes down. If you can play 3 notes this fast, there's no reason you shouldn't be able to play 8 notes that fast. If you find it hard to play it that fast, it's the string crossing that's sort of like, you know, getting in your way, and your right hand technique, and remember economy of motion as well. If you haven't subscribed to my YouTube channel, do so, and then every time I release a new tutorial, you'll get it in your inbox so you can check it out. Until next time, take it easy and get in the shed.